definitely a dreamer. Somebody who's been chasing after or running after his dreams and still doing so. Yeah.
Is fashion designing your true soul calling?
Absolutely, absolutely. I think I was in grade 4 or something, and I used to stitch clothes for my sister's Barbie. And since then, my family knew that this boy is going to be into the clothing business. At that point of time, people used to call it costume designing and not fashion designing. That makes me sound very old. But yeah, I'm not very old. So yeah, I think my family always knew about it. I always knew about it. It's definitely the passion that I grew up with. It's definitely the passion. I did not have the resources growing up. But I've always had a passion, and I think if you're really focused, you achieve whatever you want to. Once I get into a process, for example, if I'm designing a particular collection for a particular season, things start coming into my head. I don't think I really have to force myself. I really have to sit for a while and start sketching. Once first sketch is designed, then it's an easier job. Yeah, I like to believe in classic pieces. Jean represents classic pieces. Our women, they do not necessarily follow fashion or trends. They embody it. And I think trend is the last stage before tacky. So we create modern silhouettes. Of course, everything is so digital these days. You know what's going on. For example, these crazy flared sleeves are very much in, and you see them everywhere. And then, when you travel, you see all the trends, and you come back home and you see how you have to interpret that into your own culture. How you have to weave that into your culture. There's a certain body type of our women, and I think that needs to be respected. I think for fashion designers, there is not really a personal life, but I don't know if people notice it, but I don't really mingle with a lot of people. That's a conscious decision that I made, because I think you need to come back to work with a fresh mind, and you need to come back with different ideas. I love to talk about economics, I love to talk about world politics, I love to talk about geography. So if I only mingle with a particular kind of people, I don't think I can have this kind of conversation with them. So I feel that in fashion we like to indulge into more shallow conversations. We like to talk about materials and other things. I'm a social person. I don't think it's the other way around. I am, but I have a very diverse group of friends. You can have different kind of conversations with different people, not particularly bad. It's the most enriching experience of my life. I don't think I can emphasize enriching in much more stronger tone, but PID has been the most enriching experience. It made me the person who I am, the good, the bad, the ugly. I was a young boy who dreamt for PIFD all his life. Whenever PIFD bus used to pass by me, I used to think, okay, one day I'll be on this bus. But I didn't have the resources, my family didn't have the finances. So I was there on a scholarship, and the faculty, the teacher, they really helped me going through that. Obviously it was very, very tough, the routine and everything, but they really understood the background that I was coming from, and I think they really helped me. And there's a reason that I keep mentioning the financial difficulties I've had in my life, because there's so many people out there who feel that only if you have money you can make it big. No, you cannot. If you have the passion, if you have the drive, if you have the creative, you can go sky's the border. You can go anywhere. Well, two special names. It has to be Faiza, and it has to be Sara, who constantly pushed me and forced me, and who were by my side, and I have eternal respect for them. And apart from that, there's definitely Shabana, and there's Asim, who. Been driving force. Yeah. It was a life-changing experience. I myself and there were five more designers who were selected by British Council. There were 40 designers who applied for London Fashion Week. Then they selected 15. Then the 15 went through interviews, and then we had to wait. They had to evaluate the interviews, and then they selected six people. And we went through 8 months extensive training. and regarding sustainable fashion, ethical fashion, how you treat your employees and your fabrication, and there's so many things that they taught us. Like in Pakistan, there's no concept of sustainable fashion. Because of London Fashion Week, I have started wearing sustainable fabric, and I have started not buying many clothes. Because you know, you want to be responsible. People don't realize that you need 11,000 liters of water just to make one t-shirt. So you know, and the kind of washes we do on our denim that kills people so much. So we're polluting our planet so much. People don't realize it. So you know, London trip has been enriching in that experience. I got to meet some incredible people, including Safiya Miri, who's very well known and great teacher and great business people from London. And it was, we were there for like 2 weeks, and every day we were meeting interesting people. I would not have been able to meet people from Selfridges or Selfridges team, and you know, their entire section or habits, or so you know, ethical London Ethical Forum. So I met some incredible people there. I think it's super important that your fashion has to be relevant. If I make fashion, if I make clothes, if I'm a designer in Pakistan and I'm making clothes for Pakistan people, I have to respect that we have a particular kind of body type. Like our women are pear shaped. And when you're designing for European women, you know their body type, so you design accordingly. You send me India, you send me Ethiopia, you send me anywhere, I'll design clothes accordingly.
Shan Shahid or Amir Khan?
Amir Khan.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not a Shan fan.
Mahira or Deepika?
Mahira, I don't like Deepika at all.
Atif Aslam or Arjit?
Arjit.
Mumin or Radhika?
I think I'll go with Radhika.
Sheru or Kamiru?
Kamiru, anytime.
Khadi the corporate or Khadi's labor?
I think I wouldn't just answer with one word, but I think Khadi has done some immaculate work in
Pretty
Pakistan,
work, yeah.
And you know, they are the reason that everybody follows their footsteps. So Khadi all the way.
But what about the labor? Okay.
We don't have the full story.
Okay. Smartphone, gaming device, or something utilized a lot more than that?
Not a gaming device. I don't use. Okay. I don't do games. Yeah.
Coke or chai?
Chai. Chai all the time. Commercialization has taken over the world. Sadly, so many. There's so many people who are in the commercial business and who are doing such affordable fashion that designers find it hard to sustain in the business. For example, if I'm making this shirt, I may sell it for 6,000 rupees from my outlet, I'm just saying. And you go to Zara, or you go to H&M, you go to ASOS, you'll find them for 800, 1200. So, you know, the commercialization is one of the major war that we designers are facing. I think kind of true. We have a couple of designers. Yeah. Because Armani and Gucci have different branches.
It's just a metaphorical thing.
But
it's like, because Armani and Gucci is something that everybody knows.
Yeah, the name, yeah. I think it could be Ilan.
It could be Ilan.
Yeah. Or Jean.
Wow. Good.
When I was working for Stonehenge for 1 year, and when I finished my job there, I was, you know, in my head I was thinking, this is not the kind of retail that I want to get into, and I want to do something else. So I met this incredible person called Mr. Tenpur and Mr. Bilal, and they were planning on starting their own brand, and you know, everything was very immature at the time. So we collaborated, and we built this brand together, and they have been incredible force in uplifting me and making me who I am today. And it's been 4 years, four very successful years. I think it's the variety that we have. It's affordable luxury, and it's the variety that we have. We have an outfit for your bridal trousseau. We have an outfit for you to go to a normal tea, to an office. So it's the variety that makes us stand out from the rest, and definitely the affordable luxury factor. Kamiru. I think I keep mentioning this because I think he's incredibly talented, and I think there are very few people who are equally good in both Eastern wear and Western wear, and he's definitely one. It's a global phenomenon. It's not really Pakistani thing anymore. Everybody copies everybody, and it's really sad whenever people do it. We live in a digital age. Jo bhi karta hai, everybody gets caught. So you live in Paris, you live in Punjab, you live anywhere in the world, if you are doing plagiarism, you will be caught. I feel it's Prabal Gurum. Prabal is from Nepal, and he's an incredible designer in New York, and he makes relevant clothes. It's whenever you go abroad, please don't just represent your culture. It has to be viewed with the contemporary fashion of that particular area. So that's why I really like Prabal Gurum, and he also runs a foundation called Shikshaya. So there are a few things that I really, really like about him, and I also love Gucci. Gucci's incredible for the past 3 years. I think I've been following Clutchit for a while now, and I really like how innovative their content has been, and you know how they've been promoting new talent, which is incredible, and keep clutching it.